Good morning, grade 9, how are you? I hope that you are fine. Good morning, lovely morning. Our lesson today is about the electricity. First of all, I want to explain what is electricity. Electricity or electric energy is a form of energy. You can see electricity everywhere, in operating refrigerators, the washing machines, mixer, the laptop, TV, all devices need electricity. Imagine your life without electricity. Can you live without electricity? Of course not. Electricity is a type of energy that can build up from one place to another. Before explaining electricity, sure that you studied the structure of the atom. What is the atom? The atom is the smallest building unit of any matter, which composed of nucleus. Inside the nucleus, you can find positive protons and neutral neutrons. Around the nucleus, we have electrons, negatively charged particles. The electrons rotate around the nucleus. At ordinary conditions, you can find the atom neutral. But if the atom loses an electron or more, or gains an electron or more, it became charged object. Charged object may be positive or negative. So it can attract or repel another object. It can attract or repel another object. As you studied before, the opposite charges attract each other, positive and negative, they can attract each other. Okay, this is called attraction force. Or if they are similar charges, they can repel each other, so this is a repulsion force. So attraction or repulsion follows the laws of attraction and repulsion rule. The similar repel each other, while the opposite charges attract each other like magnets. North beside north, they repel, they push each other. While north and south, they attract each other. Okay? Yeah. Fine. So, electricity is very important to study. We have two types, static and current electricity. Static electricity and current electricity. Static electricity, when the charges are at rest, the accumulation of excess electric charges, positive or negative, on a body. The charges can transfer from one object to another, but remain at rest on this surface, like the comb when rubbed with hair. The comb gains electrons and became charged, can attract pieces of papers. Okay, while the dynamic or current electricity, the moving of electrons, the moving of charges in a conductor. So current electricity or dynamic electricity is the flow of free electrons or charges in a particular direction. As you see in this electric circuit, we have the source of electricity or the battery. In the battery, we have negative pole and positive pole. And the electricity or the electrons flow from negative to positive pole, from the negative pole to the positive pole, but in a closed circuit, in a closed path, closed loop. Okay? Here is the static electricity. When you wrap your hair with a comb, at the beginning, both hair and comb have equal positive and negative charges. They are neutral. After wrapping, the electrons can move, so they became charged, positive or negative. And the comb has the ability to attract pieces of paper, as you see. The electric current should flow in closed path or closed circuit. You can see the closed circuit here, the battery with the wire and the lamp closed, and the electrons movement or the electric current should move in closed circuit, not open circuit. But should the electrons should move in a conductor. What is a conductor? Any material that allows electric current to pass through is called conductor. For example, copper, aluminum, steel, iron. Any material that allow electric current to pass through it, this is called a conductor. You can see the wire, the electric wires made of copper and covered with plastic. The copper wire is a conductor to allow the electricity to pass through it, and covered with insulator to avoid electric shock, sure. Now you can compare between the conductors and insulator, the electric conductors and electric insulators. The electric conductors, materials that allow the electric energy to pass through it, like silver, gold, copper, also salt solutions, seawater, sure, is a conductor. While electrical insulator, they are the materials that doesn't allow electric energy to pass through it. For example, glass, rubber, wood, oil, and plastic. The electric current measured by a unit called ampere. The ampere is a measuring unit for measuring electric current. Here is the electric charges. The electric charge is the property of the matter that causes an attraction or repulsion force. You can see here the positive and negative charged objects. There are two types of charges, positive or negative. They can attract each other if they are oppositely charged, and they can repel each other if they are similar charges. And the electric force here depends on the amount of the charge. The greater the charge, the greater the electric force, and also the distance between charges. So the electric force is the force between charged objects, yeah, right? And the electric force depends on the amount of the charge and the distance between charges. The amount of the charge and the distance between charges. How can the charges transferred? Charges can be transferred by different methods, by friction, by conduction, by induction. Friction, conduction, and induction. We have three ways to charge an object. Here is the friction, for example, the balloon and the hair causes electrons to move from your hair to the balloon. Your hair and the balloon become oppositely charged, so they can attract each other. While by conduction, when a negatively charged plastic ruler, for example, touches an uncharged metal rod, the electrons in the ruler travel to the rod, and the rod becomes negatively charged. By which way? By conduction. Is it clear? Okay. The induction, when a negatively charged balloon makes a small section of a metal beam have a positive charge through induction. The electrons here in the metal are repelled by and move away from the balloon. So we have three ways to charge an object: friction, induction, and conduction. Friction, when electrons move from one end to another. A plastic ruler with close the electrons move from the clothes to the ruler, and the ruler gains electrons and becomes negatively charged. At the same time, the clothes loses electrons, so it becomes positively charged. Is it clear? Okay.